Johnny, in your wildest dreams, did you think you could win go today?
No, you know, in my wildest dreams, yes. But, you know, I just went out there and tried my best today. Was pretty pleased with my jump. It was a good jump, and I hadn't had a good jump in a while. I kind of struggled last week, and I really just wanted to go out there today and have a good showing.
Mind you, his teammate looks to have done exactly that, broken free from a poor patch. Johnny Spillane, also from Steamboat Springs, 125 and a half meters in warm-up, 120 in training. Fingers crossed for the Americans now. This their best hope. And he's done it. Johnny Spillane back to something like his very best, coming into the championships as the seventh best Nordic combiner of the season. Disappointing in the individual event, outside the top 20, but 124 meters here, and Johnny Spillane in with a chance of giving America maybe a medal. Great in run speed, 94.1 kilometers, fast skis for Johnny, and second spot behind Matty Mentz, but only 2 seconds the difference.
So I had a good jump, and then just wanted to go out there. I had no expectations for the race. I just wanted to do my best. Had an unbelievable pair of skis. The wax crew did an awesome job today. They really did. They pulled through for us, and just went out there. And fortunately, those guys were pretty tired the last lap, but those guys out front were kind of playing around a little bit and gave me a good chance to rest for the finish.
Look at Spillane. Spillane over the roller. United States in the lead, and Spillane skis take him there. And Johnny Spillane from Steamboat Springs storming home on the far side, and they're not going to catch him. Magna, this is a magnificent moment. United States have got their first gold of the championships. 50 to go, 20 to go. He's done it. He's won it. And he's got the gold and silver to Austria. Hettich gets the bronze, and Ackermann,
that's
nothing.
Fantastic. Spillane, and with a great skis, so I think you at least have to buy one beer to his serviceman this afternoon.
I think a bit more than one beer.
I had such a fast pair of skis, I could have probably coasted all the way to the finish and been all right today. Thank you.
So what does this mean to you?
Oh, it means so much. I think it means more for U.S. skiing than, or U.S. Nordic skiing than anything else. It's so important for us to get good results in order to have funding and have interest in the sport. And I think that hopefully this is the start of even more.
I think this is the first ever gold medal in Nordic skiing, in Nordic combined.
I think, I'm sure, I know it is Nordic combined. I'm not too sure about rest of Nordic skiing.
Well, you got to go back to Bill Cocker, I mean.
Yeah, for sure back to there. So I'm pretty pleased with this for sure.
So is this the next Bodie Miller in the Nordic?
I hope so. Bodie's pretty good.
Congratulations, Johnny. Thanks for talking to us.
Thank you very
much. Now, here, this was an indication of Spillane's confidence that he was prepared to go the long way round to get the better of Georg Hettich, to put himself in a challenging position. It didn't actually work out the way that he thought, because he opened the door for Hettich to counter-attack on the inside, but carrying the speed, he really pushed into the roller and took the speed over and went away from them, and he went away from them with real power. And that is not just a snatch victory, that is a commanding one.
Yes, fantastic.
And all credit to Georg Hettich getting the bronze. Remember, he lost out in the individual race, and he's got good consolation, so the top jumper gets a medal, which is terrific. Oh, in fact, am I wrong?
Yes,
I am wrong.
The bronze medal.
I am wrong. It's Gottwald who's got the bronze, and Hettich who's got fourth place again. So my apologies to Felix Gottwald in all the excitement.
So Felix, that was one heck of a finish.
Yeah, it was really very hard for us, and I think interesting for the spectators. Johnny was doing a great race today. He was just running behind us, and he tried to use this hour for him. And he had very fast skis in the last downhill, and of course he had a lot of power left. And Ronnie and me, maybe we had a bit lost too much power, especially me on the top. I wanted to attack, but it was not that effective on the last two races. And of course I'm getting tired too, and I'm no machine, but I'm more than happy with my three medals. And it's a whole set now, and it's really a lot of fun for me here in Predazzo.
Well, that's a tremendous finale. We said that Johnny had a chance, but I think, to be honest, Magna, we thought that this was going to be between Ronny Ackermann and Felix Gottwald. And here, maybe I can get it right. There indeed is Felix Gottwald lunging ahead of Georg Hettich. So commiserations to Georg Hettich. This time, less than a second away from a bronze medal.
Also, the Norwegians make a great run the first two laps, and it was looking interesting for the medals, but they burned out too much energy and have no chance at the last lap.
But it does emphasize, Magna, that on this particular day, you have to be good at both disciplines. You cannot afford to give away meters in terms of the jumping. If you look back at Gresley, 120 and a half meters, but that's 8.5 behind Hettich, 7 behind Ackermann, and 4 behind Johnny Spillane.
Nancy,
yes.
You came here, I expect, just for a little holiday, but that's a great way to end it.
No, we actually came right to see Johnny. That's the only reason we came.
What were your expectations before this?
Well, we were hoping he would stay in the top 10.
Well,
yeah, he did. He stayed in the top 10, so that's good.
Any idea that he was going to win a gold medal?
No, but that's always been his dream, so we're absolutely thrilled for him. Yeah.
So you've obviously supported him throughout his career.
Absolutely, absolutely. We have followed him all around the world, yeah.
And what will this mean for yourself and America?
Well, I'm so excited for the United States. I think someone told me it was the first Nordic medal ever. Is that true? Yeah. Do you know? Is that true? Yeah, so we're very excited for the whole Nordic group of people because they work so hard, yeah.
I think it's good Miller's getting all the attention now, perhaps your son.
I know. Someone said to me the other day, they said something about Nordic, and then they said, but you have Bodie Miller. And I said, but I have Johnny Spillane. Now I really have Johnny Spillane, yeah.
Great, congratulations, yeah, thanks for talking to us.
Thank you.
They'll be drinking all day and all night in Steamboat Springs. It is really time for us to take our leave. We'll see you this evening. From Magna and myself, David Goldstrom, bye-bye.
Eurosport Live. With Buderus, your partner for modern heating systems.
Good morning and welcome to the penultimate competition day at the Nordic Ski World Championships. First off today, Hans Peder Pohl introduces us to the final Nordic combined competition. Well, the sprint, as it's known today, consists of the 7.5 kilometer cross country and one jump on the big hill, where Adam Małysz jumped to a record distance of 136 meters in the individual specialist competition. Well, in this event here today, everybody has to make a good time, a good jump, as there's no second chance. And you need some luck on this big hill. I think Gottwald, Ronny Ackermann and Sampa Lajunen are the favourites, as they were in the individual competition. But watch out also for Georg Hettich, who's jumped very well in training, Bjarke Kaisen, and they start as the favorites to take the gold. Here's Felix Gottwald.
Yeah, of course, I like the hill. It's nice to jump on the big hill now. And in the sprint competition, everything can happen. So it's just one jump and 7.5 kilometers. There are a lot of favorites. And I tried just to enjoy the whole championships, and I want to do it on Friday as well.
Well, what about Sampa Lajunen, triple Olympic gold medalist? What about his chances?
It feels a little bit strange after smaller hill, and I think because it feels strange, I have some technique problems in the jumping table. I believe if I want to win a sprint competition, I have to jump to top. It's for sure.
Yeah. Well, Ackermann already has a gold medal from these championships. Can he get a second one?
Ist mir eigentlich egal. Ich versuche jetzt einfach die letzten Tage zu genießen, die ganze Stimmung hier noch aufzunehmen. Und was dann beim Sprint rauskommt, ist mir eigentlich sekundär.
So there the thoughts of some of the men who may well feature this afternoon after the cross-country sprint. But here we are live for the jumping phase of this competition on the big hill, the one to the right as you're looking at the screen. So it is the Nordic combined sprint, only in the World Championships for the third time. First time was Ramsau in 1999, when the champion was Norway's Bjarte Engenvik. And then the title went to Germany in 2001. Marco Bakker, who was then seriously injured in a fall 12 months ago, he took the title, and he's in today's field to defend that title. So that's really good news. So who will win this competition? Well, I can tell you it really does concern the favourites, because incredibly, in yesterday's training round, there were three training jumps. The analysis shows up what a low quality competition this really is. It's a horrible thing to say, but of the 69 on the training list, only 11 managed to reach the calculation point. And of those 11, only 5 managed to get over 120 metres in every single jump that they took. So I have to say that you're really looking at outsiders when we start the jumping phase, because as in the individual competition where there are two jumps, here the jumping becomes even more important. If you fail on the first jump, then you really don't have any chance in the cross country. The conversion factor here is 15 points per minute or 4 points per second. The calculation line, 120 meters. Now, compared with the special jumping, it's 1.2 points per meter for every meter beyond the calculation line. That compares with 1.8 points for the specialists. Well, we've got a little bit of time on our hands, so what we're going to do is take a break so that we can bring you uninterrupted coverage of the jumping. So we'll be back very shortly for Thomas Slavik, who'll be first to jump.
Left, a little to the left. A little bit, now a little bit more back. Back, go back. Good. To the right.
In every moment of the year, Sicily is so beautiful, you won't want to see anything else.
Down. Okay.
Sicily, everything else is in the shade.
Together for the first time. A unique 8-CD box set featuring some of the finest music that you'll ever experience. 8 CDs of relaxing music to help you unwind and ease the stress of modern living. A certain remedy for a world that continues to move faster and faster. Chill out moods. Over 8 hours of beautiful music to soothe your spirit and ease your soul. Calming, peaceful, and incredible value. But that's not all. When you buy Chill Out Moods, you'll get an exclusive CD of Feng Shui music absolutely free. Call now. All the Chill Out music you'll ever need in one superb collection. The Music for Your Way of Life, a unique collection. Euphoric and uplifting, 3 decades of stunning music for your way of life. 8 CDs of Chill Out Moods. Not forgetting our special and exclusive free gift. Don't miss out on this superb television offer. Call now.
The Quest.
quest for the Holy Grail is almost over. For 8 years, the America's Cup has been held securely by New Zealand. But now they're forced to fight for it again. They've been training relentlessly in their restless home waters to be ready for the challenge. The challenge led by the man who was their skipper in the last campaign and who jumped ship to command the crew of the Swiss yacht Alinghi. Now, dead set on carrying off the cup to Europe for the first time in its long history. The America's Cup, tonight on Eurosport. With UBS, Financial Services Group. With Buderus, your partner for modern heating systems.
So a very good morning to you from Predazzo for this final Nordic combined competition of the 2003 championships. These are the competitors who will challenge for this one jump, 7.5 kilometer sprint cross country competition for only in the championships for the third time. In 1999, it was Bjarte Engenvik of Norway who was the champion. Marco Bakker took the title in 2001. So who will be the champion this day? This morning, we start rather early again with the jumping on the big hill as opposed to the small hill which was used for the individual competition which Ronnie Ackermann won earlier in the championships. So the calculation line at 120 meters, the bonus and deduction factor, 1.2 points for every meter beyond or short of that line. That's the factor which will be used. And the conversion at the end of the round of jumping to decide the time interval for the pursuit race, 4 points per 4 seconds per point or 15 points per minute. So jumping absolutely at a premium. The hill record here, 136 meters, and that was set by Adam Mawish on the big hill competition here with an in-run speed of 92.6, and that was out of gate number 15. So it'll be very interesting to make the comparison when we get underway. Well, this is the weather this morning, and for the first time in the championships, we have a real change. The blue sky, which was absolutely solid all the way through since the first day on the 18th, well, now we've got some clouds. So temperatures are warming up, and that's going to make it a little bit more testing later this morning when we go live to the women's 30 kilometer cross-country freestyle race. So here we are now, not the biggest crowd in the world. In fact, the crowd figures by comparison of some of the Nordic venues, pretty modest, I have to say. But the kids have got a day off and they're here to see the best Nordic combiners in the world. So stay with us for about 45 minutes now to see who will have the longest jumps and who will have the best chance for the cross-country race later on today. So just about to get underway, that's the first man, that's Thomas Slavik from Harakov, who will get us underway, representing the Czech Republic. And the interesting factor, as I mentioned earlier on, is the overall poor quality that we've seen in preparations for this competition. Only of 11 of the 69 in training actually reached the 120 meter K point, and of those, only five did it on every single jump. There were three training jumps yesterday. Well, 128 and a half meters by Christoph Bieler was the longest distance done in the trial round about half an hour ago. That was out of gate 19, and that was out of gate 20, I should say, and they've now dropped back to gate 19 for the competition proper. So Slavik now. And that is a good 20 meters short of the calculation line. Around 102, 103 meters, in fact, but still, it's a long way back. Remember, he's losing 1.2 points for every meter short of that red line, and so 103 meters. There will be others, I fear, who will not be as far as this young man. 40th in the individual event, Thomas Slavik. Now, here's Peter Dicker for Slovakia. Three training jumps yesterday, and the furthest he got, 91 and a half meters. The furthest this morning, 84 meters. And he's in that sort of territory again, I'm afraid. 48th. in the individual competition. In fact, 93.5 meters, so that is his best jump off gate 19. So Peter Dicker will be starting way back in the cross-country race. Alexander Diajula of Belarus, 20 years of age, from Minsk, Belarus. They've only got about 20 Nordic combiners in the whole country, but this young man is the best of the lot, their champion. Over the 70, 80, and again, low 90s, looking for 95 meters there, the Belarus man who hit 96 and a half meters yesterday in training. That was his longest jump, and this is pretty well around the same area, but rather unstable in flight. The wind is a backwind, as it has been all the way through these championships, and 16's the top mark that he will carry forward to add to his distance marks, because the 16 and a half as the highest, together with one of the 16s, will be discarded. Ukraine now, Diachuk. Sergei Diachuk, again outside the top 40 in the individual competition. And that is just over 80 meters. So still Thomas Slavik, who started with bib number one, leading at the moment, but 58 on the start list. Ronnie Ackerman, the gold medalist from the individual two-jump 15-kilometer event. Gottwald, the silver medalist, and Leijonen, the bronze. But the Finns have had big problems here, particularly their major stars. They haven't got to grips with this hill, and Manninen and Leijonen are far from being favorites today. The team event, just to remind you how that went, Austria, Germany, and Finland. The medalists there, Austria, terrific gold medal, and as often happens with relay squads, they rose above themselves to take that competition. Every single one of them, Dennefil and Gruber and Bieler and Gottwald, anchored them home. Very, very good. Gottwald, if he's close enough, he could be good enough to go one better and get the gold medal today, but it's all going to be about the jumping, putting himself in a position to attack. Yevgeny Penegin for Russia, that's the best jump so far, 106 and a half meters. Second in the Russian championships, outside the top 30 here in the world. But he's only 21, so some hope for the Russians. Poland, their sole representative in the air, and over 90 meters. It's not a question of qualifying, although one or two people think that maybe that would be a good incentive here. I certainly subscribe to that. I'd like to see the Nordic combined competitors pushed a little bit more, particularly at the lower end. I think they ought to be forced to maybe qualify to get into the top 40 to start the competition, and then there's maybe an argument that the top 30 go through to the cross-country race. Your thoughts on that, maybe, to our email site, ski@infovoice.de. Dejan Plevnik of Slovenia. Now, he did get over 103 meters this morning. And that's a good jump. Good effort there by Plevnik. And that's a little bit more encouraging. Sixth in the sprint competition in the Junior World Championships, which were won, of course, by Björn Kirkeisen. So a promising start by Plevnik there. Young man with, hopefully, the Slovenians believe, a future. So 112 meters, eight short of the calculation line, but the best we've got so far. So Ukraine, not particularly well timed that, and 90 meters just over that mark there. But it is a little better than he did in warm-up today, but not as good as yesterday. None of the jumpers that you've seen so far, none of them managed to reach the calculation line in any of their training jumps here yesterday. Incidentally, those were all off gate 19, exactly the same gate which they're launching themselves out of today. Really poor, he was off balance, as you could see, missed time, skis aren't parallel, scrappy telemark, 15s. A lot of work to be done. Now Italy from Predazzo, so literally a kilometer down the road. Daniele Munari for the host nation. And 90 meters, policeman by occupation, 24th in the Junior World Championships. That was in the individual event.